According to main points, you can speak well regarding presentation. There are 6 to 7 points, and you can start your presentation in this way. Yes, first of all, anyone can take a start. Who will take a start first now? Let us start presentation for 3 minutes. Yes, who will take a start first?
Yes,
Yeah,
sir.
okay. Okay, Fazlur Rahman, you have to take a
Yes.
start, and Zubair will
Hi.
take a start. Yes, Fazlur Rahman, first you
Yes.
must start your presentation on unemployment.
First of all, the definition of employment, if a large number of people are jobless in any country, then it's called unemployment. In a large number of people without job, it's called unemployment. Majority of people, if they jobless, then it's called unemployment. And people have no not opportunity in their country, it's called unemployment. Why unemployment take the place in the countries? Man, what's the main factor of this employment is creating by these things? Our population is the main factor of which they create the unemployment in the countries. Because if the people, if the population is our, then automatically sources will be less for the people of their countries. And secondly, due to misplanning of government and due to government don't efficient due to failure of defense system of the government, then unemployment take the place. And illiteracy is also a main factor, a major factor of the unemployment. Due to illiteracy and illiterate people is due to illiterate people, then unemployment is come and take the place.
Good, good. Okay, Aldevan, well done. Yes, Faiz. Yes, Zubair, get to start now.
Yes. Yes, sir.
The voice problem, I think so.
Yes, sir. I think signal, sir, is
Signal problem. Yes,
no,
signal
weak, sir.
problem.
Signal weak. So I will try, sir.
Okay.
If large number of peoples are jobless in any country, then it is called unemployment. Or if there are shortage of opportunities in any country, so unemployment take place these countries. And background is our overpopulation is any country, so automatically the sources of income are less in this country. Secondly, government are not efficient or not efficient, so the unemployment take place due to misplanning of government. And secondly, problem is illiteracy, sir. Illiteracy is a major role in unemployment. because mostly people are uneducated or unexperienced. So this situation take the unemployment, sir. So because of illiteracy, people are not conscious about skills in different fields. People can't learn the skills or educations due to or expensive educations, especially in the Pakistan. So it is a major role about the unemployment there. And at the end, most people get education, higher education, but they not conscious about English language. So during interviews, they face the difficulties of their jobs. So in this view, many people can't get the job. So it is a fact of unemployment. That's it, sir.
Okay, good try. Yes, Mubashir Said. Mubashir Said was present yesterday or not? Mubashir Said? Yes, Sajjad. You have to speak for 3 minutes. Sajjad, let us start now.
Sorry, sir.
Okay, Zain, let us start now.
Okay, sir. If a numberless people without job, this is called unemployment. If a large number of people are jobless in any country, this is called unemployment. Everybody feel bread because this is fundamental need. People have no source of income. So what do people in this situation? People will do snatching, robbery, speak a lie, corruption. People do murder for money. People need money because they are jobless. That's why people do that kind of things. Illiteracy is major problem. If a large number of people uneducated in any country, those people take the part of criminals. Mostly people can't afford the fee in educational institute. It is impossible to afford the educational skills. People cannot get the job. In this situation, people unemployed. Mostly people are unexperienced, so people are jobless. Mostly people are unconscious about English language. That's it, sir.
Oh, quite well. So, you know, it is a very important topic, and daily we have to discuss about unemployment. Daily we have to discuss about Pakistan. Daily we have to discuss about habits. And you know that these are very, daily we have to discuss about religions. So these are common things we have to discuss in Urdu, but here we have to, you know, in a practical life and in a routine life, we have to talk in English. So you can improve well your language by practice. So, you have to try to make short sentences. Don't try to make long sentences. If you have to try to make long sentence, so mostly many times it happens that you have to stuck there, that where we have to go, you don't know where you have to go. If you have to make short sentence, then easily you can grip on sentence in this way. As I told you that if you have to talk about present, then you have to prefer to present definite tense. If you want to talk about past, then you have to prefer past definite tense. If you want to talk about future, then you have to prefer future definite tense. By these three tenses, you can make short and easy sentences. It is very precious tip regarding speaking English language. You can avoid from many hurdles and obstacles. You should know that what word you have to speak next in any sentence, if you make any sentence. First of all, it is the first way that you have to make sentence in Urdu, and you should create this ability. You must create this ability that immediately you have to change any sentence from Urdu to English. You have to create this capability or ability in you. How it is possible? Just by practice. And try to avoid to make long sentences. I advise you. So I'm much happy that day by day you are improving yourself. It is a good sign for you. But especially I want to talk with Sajjad. Sajjad does not take part in question answers and presentation. It is not a good thing, Sajjad.
Yes, sir.
What problems you have to face? Why you don't take part in question answers and presentations? Do you have any complaint from me?
Sir.
Yes, what is problem?
Sir, the problem is talking, sir.
No, I tell you one thing, that you have to speak here. You don't care about you have to speak wrong English or right English. You have to speak correct English or incorrect English, but you have to speak, Sajjad. Language class.
Okay, sir.
I appreciate to other colleagues. Your other colleagues also, speak English, and they try to speak right English, correct English. It's a good sign. Same here, Sajjad. You can speak well. You can get help from your colleagues, Fazlur Rahman, Zubair, Zain. Okay, all colleagues are very cooperative. You can get help from them, no problem. You can speak English with them. You can talk in English with them on cell phone, no problem. You can
talk on
WhatsApp, no problem. Sajjad?
Yes, sir.
Yes, I know that you can improve yourself rapidly. I know that, but problem is here that you have to take first step. You don't care about it that you have to speak wrong English or correct English, but you have to speak. Then you can improve yourself day by day, Sajjad. Okay.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir.
I am much hopeful that you will follow my instructions. Anyways, so tomorrow I have to start a new briefing, and I have to speak on skills tomorrow. Okay, skills. Very important topic. Very important briefing I will give you tomorrow on skills. And in your common conversation, everybody have to use vocabulary. If you talk with somebody, you have to use vocabulary in your conversation. So inshallah you will improve yourself rapidly. And as usual, you have to speak slow. It is good sign for everybody. Any question regarding unemployment about today's topic?
No, sir.
No question?
No. Sir, I have one question about the final test.
About?
Final test, sir.
Final test?
Yes, sir.
Final test, you know that after briefings, there are 10 dialogues, Babashir.
Yes, sir.
Then I will take your final test of this class, including you. Okay?
In which date? In which date, sir?
What date? Most probably in the next month.
It's been 1st January.
No, most probably, how many topics we have completed? How many briefings we have done?
I think six, sir.
Six. Okay, it means four briefings left and 10 dialogues left. Most probably, inshallah, in the mid of January, or inshallah,
yes, sir,
till 20th January, I will take final test of this class, inshallah.
Okay, sir.
Everybody have to listen it.
Sir.
So,
sir, I will announce it here. I can I make a WhatsApp group for English in which everyone can speak English.
Okay. Okay. You can contact with your colleagues now in this matter.
Already.
Yes, sir.
You can contact, you know, that on 1st January.
Sir,
Okay, very important message for you. You sent message and also informed you that from 1st January, everybody have to come to academy. Okay, then offline classes will start, then online classes will finish. From 1st January,
sir,
2021. Yes.
Sir, which time I will come?
Same time, 7 p.m. to 8 p.m. Everybody have to come. Same time in class,
sir, I,
1st January.
Sir, I have a class in madrasa. That's why I not come to 7 to 8.
You
sir,
can't
I
come?
Take class in madrasa. That's why I not come. Yes, sir. 7 to 8, I have not come.
That time. You come to academy, then discuss with it.
So, I tell you one thing. It is much better your colleagues can...
Yes, sir.
Your colleagues can help you in this matter, no problem. Okay, if you you have to come to academy on 31st December, you meet with me. Okay, Babashir.
Okay, sir.
I think about yourself.
Yes, sir.
I think then I will take the scene about you. I will also talk with principal about this matter. Got it now?
Okay.
So we can solve this issue, no problem. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Okay.
So class is going to.
Thank you, sir.
Oh, welcome. So any question? Any student?
No, sir.
No, sir.
No questions?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Okay, so class is going to end now. Wish you good luck. Allah Hafiz.
Okay, Allah Hafiz.
Allah Hafiz.